Why do politicians have to be reminded by the media about their responsibility? Rahul Sinha is Arunima's brother. Rahul is joining us from Lucknow. Michael Ferreira, former world billiards champion. Nawab Kazim Ali is a ruling party MLA of the BSP from Uttar Pradesh. Ranjana Kumari, well-known activist, director of the Center for Social Research. Rahul, पहले मैं आपसे पूछना चाहूंगा कि आपके बहन के साथ जो ये हुआ, इसके बाद पहले हमने देखा कि कुछ नहीं हुआ, फिर किसी ने कहा 5,000 रुपए देंगे, 25,000 रुपए देंगे
जी।
ऐसा लग रहा है कि अगर मीडिया इस बात को नहीं उठाती तो कोई राजनेता, कोई पॉलिटिशियन, कोई मंत्री
जी
सोचते भी नहीं अरुणिमा के बारे में
जी। जी शायद ऐसा है सर, कहीं ना कहीं ये बात आपकी हम सही मानते हैं सर, क्योंकि इसके पहले का जो भी प्रोग्राम था सर, चाहे प्रशासन का था या उच्च अधिकारियों का था
जी,
कोई खास नहीं था सर। जब तुम पहुंचे, हम रात के लगभग 8 बजे पहुंचे हैं सर, उस समय तक सर कोई ऐसी स्थिति नहीं दिख रही थी जिससे ये लगे कि हमारी बहन के साथ कोई सिंपैथी जताई जा रही हो, चाहे सरकार की तरफ से या प्रशासन की तरफ से। और इस हालात में मेरी सिस्टर पहुंच गई है, तो हम ये चाहेंगे सर कि सरकार से ये गुजारिश है हमारी कि वो अब उस वक्त ना सही, कम से कम अब इस वक्त तो हमारी सिस्टर के साथ न्यायपूर्वक फैसला सुनाए, और जो फैसला सुनाया गया है उसके अनुसार वो अपना काम करके दिखाए और हमारे विश्वास को और मजबूत वो बनाए। ये हम कानून और प्रशासन और उच्च अधिकारियों से विनम्र निवेदन करता हूँ सर।
आप अपनी बात इतनी अच्छी तरीके से रख रहे हैं, मगर सारे देश में
जी सर
बहुत ही दुख
जी सर,
गुस्सा और आक्रोश है
जी सर
कि आपके बहन के साथ जो ये हुआ, और सब और गुस्सा लोगों का ये है कि इधर ना ममता बनर्जी ना मायावती समझती है कि वो उनका रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है। ममता बनर्जी कहती है मायावती का है, मायावती कहती है ममता बनर्जी की रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है
जी। जी जी सर, जी सर, अब ये तो उनका अपने अंदरूनिक मामला एक दूसरे के ऊपर थोपने के, लेकिन इस संसार में रहने वाले लोगों के साथ तो उनके साथ उनको एक हम लोग इस दर्जे पे बैठाए हुए हैं कि जिस दर्जे पे ये पहली मानसिकता इंसानियत को देनी चाहिए, ना कि एक दूसरे के ऊपर थोपने की सर। जो भी लोग हैं उच्च अधिकारी हमारे, एक दूसरे की गलतियां बताने के बजाय एक दूसरे की मदद करने के लिए ये दिमाग लगाना चाहिए सर कि वो कहें कि उनकी गलती है या वो कहें उनकी गलती है सर, ये बात बहुत महत्वपूर्ण नहीं है, बल्कि जिसके ऊपर कष्ट पड़ा हो उसकी मदद करें, ये बात महत्वपूर्ण रखती है सर
जी। राहुल,
हेलो
जी राहुल, नहीं आपकी बात आपने रखी और सारे देश ने सुनी है, द होल कंट्री हैज हर्ड यू, यू हैव पुट योर पॉइंट सो वेल। नवाब काजिम अली
जी,
माय क्वेश्चन इज टू नवाब काजिम अली, नवाब काजिम अली, व्हाट इज गोइंग ऑन? I mean, does your government need to be reminded about its basic responsibility? Is there no caring?
See, Arnav, let me just make my point. For number one, it was the most unfortunate incident, and our sympathies are with the victim. The UP government sympathies are with the victims, and the fact is that as soon as this incident had occurred, the UP government got cracking on finding out who the 3 or 4 antisocial elements were who committed the senior's crime. They are trying to disclose their identity and they've got cracking on it. Now, when this show started, I saw some clips from the, like, for instance, it was the former Chief Minister of Madhya Pradesh saying that, you know, making a statement. I mean, that is totally a political statement, and it was made in a way as though the UP assembly elections are going to be next.
No, week, I don't want you to politicize it.
That is highly irresponsible.
No, I don't want you to politicize it.
And again, I mean, I was watching you talk to the victim's brother, and I think you said something to the effect that the UP chief minister has said that this is so-and-so's responsibility. I don't think the UP chief minister has so far given a statement on this.
That is the worst part of it.
And as soon as she gives a statement on this, I'm sure you will be well aware of the contents of the statement.
I am asking you tonight.
The UP government is analyzing the situation.
Nawab Kazim Ali, let me ask you something.
Let me finish, Arnav.
Let me ask you something.
Let me finish, Arnav. The fact is that the fact is that no amount of compensation is enough. That is a fact. But the UP government is trying their best to see what is the most, what would be the best for the victim.
Yes.
At this point, and this incident happened, say, around 24 hours ago. So you have to give some time for the results to come out.
No, I mean,
Like, you know, you are just saying that you the moment it happens and you need the investigation complete and you want the results out. It's not fair to always point out
the way responsible MLA is talking.
You don't even know who those four antisocial elements are. I mean, you are presuming they were from UP. They can be from anywhere. And the fact is, the security of the passengers on any train.
I mean, you know, one second.
The railway police is kept.
No.
So that.
Oh my God. Can we not have this blame game going on? I mean, look at the kind of points you are raising, Kazimali. Now you've spoken. Now let me say something here. You are saying we don't know where they came from. So, you know, if they came from another state, it's that state's responsibility. It's the railway police should look into it.
No.
It just happened.
The investigation comes out with all the details on the identity of the culprits. I mean, if there's an investigation, it's a thorough investigation.
Not even a statement?
Why it happened, how it happened, all that has to be done.
Not even a statement. She's lost her leg.
The state government is doing their best to get results out of this tragic incident that happened.
I'm going to get Ranjana Kumari to respond. I'll come in later. Yes, Ranjana Kumari first.
Arnav, I'm appalled by the reaction from the UP MLA. It's a shameful reaction. I think what he's talking about, almost like as if some kind of an investigation agency is, minimum they could have done is to support, instead of blame game, instead of looking into all kinds of, you know, who, where, who did it. Fact is that it happened in UP. A group of gangsters entered in train. They always do that. They make life miserable of the people inside the compartments. Anybody who's traveling by train, any woman alone traveling by train can vouch for this with me this evening. And also I can tell you that first reaction should have been to take care of the health of the girl, to announce some kind of a support for her, and also at least a visit to see a sports person. They do have a sports minister in UP, don't they have? Can't they go, one of these MLAs, the one who's talking
it
this
shows
evening,
apathy.
Can't they go and visit her and see what is the condition?
It shows apathy.
You know, this is what happens in this kind of a blame game. Nobody is worried about security and safety of women inside the train. I'm really saddened by the fact that Mamata Banerjee and Mayawati, both are women. We talk at top of our voice about more and more women in governance, but this kind of negligence and this kind of a reaction, no empathy. Nobody she could send to meet her. Nobody she could. They announce big compensations and big rewards for people who are political people who are in other sports.
Let me get Michael Ferreira.
I'm sorry that in cricket they would give 5 crores. They would give sports person's life has been made miserable by
the way she was pushed out of the train. I'll tell you why. Because they give the money to cricketers so they can take photographs with them and then hope that the popularity of the cricketers rubs off on them and they don't care for the average citizen. Michael Ferreira, I would like you to respond to what the UP MLA has said tonight.
I'm really shocked at the smokescreen that is being thrown at us. What sort of lack of empathy, what lack of fellow feeling, my goodness. You know, it seems to me, first of all, that the UP government has failed miserably. The chief minister has done nothing. She's a woman. She should be up in arms and saying, what the heck should we do? Well, first of all, look at the victim. Secondly, spread a dragnet for these criminals. Third, what is Mamata Banerjee doing? She's the railway minister, doing what these guys do best, scrambling for votes. I think it is absolutely shocking. Of course, this was an athlete, so this has been thrown into bold relief. What about if it had been one of the Aam Aadmi? Come on. I mean, the UP is like a barbaric state. We've got to do something about it. And unless we as citizens raise our voices, nothing is going to be done.
I have
statue,
simply one question.
Erections will continue.
One question for Kazim Ali. Nawab Kazim Ali, I have one simple question for you. And that question is this. How busy is Mayawati? How terribly busy is she that she cannot... 1 minute, sir. that she cannot, I'm not saying go meet her, I'm not saying show empathy, I'm not even saying do something, that she cannot issue a 7-word sentence, speak even one sentence on this case. When the, assure the people, not even a, that shows, you know, you can, it's not even apathy, it's complete arrogance. That I, not even to say I will not let the culprits escape, she doesn't care to even say that. The whole country is asking how this happened. How important and how busy is Mayawati tonight? How can this be allowed? You cannot say we are busy, it's 24 hours. How busy is busy?
Let me tell you, Arnav, it's very easy to accuse anybody of anything.
No, I'm asking you a question. You answer my question.
This person, Mr. Michael Pereira, it's very easy to make a statement that UP is a barbaric state and nothing has happened. Let me tell you something. 2 weeks ago, on the UP-Uttarakhand border, Rampur district and Kashipur district being in Uttarakhand and Rampur being in UP, an unmanned railway crossing, a train went over 4 women. This was 2 weeks ago. And they were armed, I mean, they were ordinary women. They were women living in Rampur district seeking jobs in Uttarakhand, in Kashipur, going on a daily wages, they were going up for a daily wages job. And
answer
when that happened,
question.
The Rampur district administration was the first to react. They all gave them compensation.
Answer my question.
They gave them houses. The UP government, the UP chief minister, immediately gave them money so that because they were poor people.
No, I'm answer my question.
I mean, they didn't even have proper houses made of bricks. They were living in mud houses.
What kind of answer is that?
Immediately everything was announced to them. And Ranjana is just making a statement that she's appalled and she's shocked and everything. She's sitting in Lucknow and making the statement.